على مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى من الرحمن يهدينا.
اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي بحق حبيبنا وسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. آمين يا رب العالمين. My respected viewers of ITV, I greet you with the universal greetings of peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. On this beautiful day of Ramadan, in this glorious month of Ramadan, while we are fasting for His sake and to gain His divine pleasure, we beseech Almighty Allah to bestow His peace, blessings, and eternal salams on our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and everyone until the end of time. Today, I welcome you again to one of the gems from the gems of the Quran, and that is the 8th surah of the Quran, which is called Suratul Anfal. The word Anfal means booty, or what we call the spoils of war. This surah is so profound because here Almighty Allah makes direct mention of the reality of life. Because from time to time you find war breaks out between nations, between tribes, and between two groups of people. And then there is the strive and the fight for the spoils of war. Here in the surah, in the very beginning, Almighty Allah makes mention of this fact by saying, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَنْفَالِ. O my beloved Prophet, they ask you concerning the spoils of war. قُلِ الْأَنْفَالِ لِلَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. Say to them that in essence, the spoils of war and the booty belongs to Almighty Allah and to His beloved Rasul, to His Prophet. فَاتَّقُ اللَّهِ. So fear Allah with regard to every issue that you face. وَأَصْلِحُ ذَاتَ بَيْنِكُمْ. And reconcile and keep the pact and the peace beautiful between all of you. وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. And obey Allah and obey His Prophet if you are indeed true believers. So here Almighty Allah refers to the fact that we need to sit and realize that the spoils of war, even though we fight for it, and we gain it through victory of war, and we lay ownership and claim to it, essentially it belongs to Allah. By extension of this understanding, we might achieve great benefits from big investments, or profitable investments, or profitable business deals. Let us not forget that all this belongs to Allah. For everything in the heavens and the earth belongs to Him and to Him alone. And He gives and He takes. And it is up to us to show appreciation for His blessings and spend that wealth that He has given us in the right direction. But then Almighty Allah shift the focus from the spoils of war to a more deeper sense, a deeper sense of discussion, a deeper sense of understanding. And Allah describes the true believers by saying, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. Allah says, verily the true believers are those whose hearts tremble when Allah's name is mentioned, or when the ayat and the signs of Allah is mentioned. The believers' hearts tremble and shiver out of divine reverence for Him. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِمَانًا. And when the laws of Allah and His ayat and His signs are rehearsed to them, their iman, their faith, and their conviction in the belief of Almighty Allah increases in their hearts. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ And this lead to their total dependence and their reliance only on Almighty Allah. So you can see how Allah changes surah from the attention of spoils of war to the condition of one's heart. For that is core. If the heart is right, then everything is right. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ says in a hadith that there's a piece of flesh in the human being, a special component. If that component is right, then the whole body is right. And if that component is bad and corrupt, then the whole person will be bad and corrupt. Allah wa hiya al-qalb. Know for sure that that is the heart. And this is the heart that Allah refers to, that inner heart, which is supposed to be the seat of the glory of Allah, the seat of the knowledge of Almighty Allah, that no greed should sit on the throne of our hearts. That's where Allah deals with wealth in the beginning of this chapter, of this surah, of this beautiful gem of the Quran, and then Allah takes the focus and shifts it to the condition and the situation of the heart. So as believers, we need to constantly focus. We need to take deep stock of ourselves and ask ourselves that when I hear about my Creator and His almightiness and His ever-knowingness, that He is closer to me than my jugular vein, my life vein in my neck, that knowledge alone of my Creator, does my heart tremble for Him? Does my heart shiver because of His divine majesty? The second question we need to ask ourselves, that when His signs are rehearsed to me, I hear about His ayat, I hear about how He dealt with the nations before us, and the consequences of our evil deeds that will await us. Does my heart tremble, and does it increase my faith? Because faith is something, iman is something that goes up and down. Maybe the state of my iman today is not how my state of iman was yesterday. And my concern is, how will it be tomorrow? And my greater concern is, what will be the level of my iman, the level of my faith, the level of my conviction in Allah, when the angel of death stands in front of me and he needs to take me from this physical abode into the next abode? What will be the situation and the level of my faith when I am going to meet Almighty Allah in His divine supreme court on the day of judgment, that inevitable day when every human being from the time of Adam, Nabi Adam alayhi salam, to the last person that must still be born, what will be my situation and condition and level of iman when I stand in front of His majestic presence in His divine supreme court on that inevitable day of judgment? The third question we need to ask ourselves, have we established the five daily salahs that Allah has ordered us? Because this is what the level of iman should do, that I should look forward to converse with my Creator five times a day as He has prescribed upon me. That five daily conversations, that five daily conversations to stand in His presence, to worship Him and ask of Him only. That is called the salah. And the other question, the final question that we need to ask ourselves, the spoils of war or the benefit of business and investments and the wealth that Allah has given us, how did we earn it and how did we spend it? For no foot will move on the day of judgment unless and until you are asked about your earnings, how you earned it and how you spend it. Let this gem of the Quran, Suratul Anfal, the spoils of war, let it be a great lesson for us to sit, to think, to reflect deeply in all the divine favors of Allah. For Allah say, innama al-amwal, innama auladukum wa auladukum fitna, that Allah has made your children and your wealth a test and a trial for you. May Allah bless us and may Allah keep us in His grace. Ameen. Until tomorrow, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
نور على مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى من الرحمن يهدينا به للصالحات وللمكارم والتقى نور على مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى